Hi everyone, it's Taff. Welcome back to Farm Sim 15. Here we are in Bjornholm. As you can see, our little Deutz is just parked up with our new trailer, which we bought last time. And I have been going back and forth using the mission board to sell the grain we got from the ancient coins we threw down the washing well. Here we are. This is the current status. We have 95,000 litres left of wheat. We have 200,000 of barley, which hadn't been touched, 32,000 of canola, 53,000 of corn, and the potatoes, sugar beet, and wood chips have not been touched. Also, so I haven't sold a great deal, but thanks to the missions, we'll just skip along. Boom! Mission income, £851,000. Harvest income, £156,000, which has given us a grand total of just over £1 million. £1 million. And we've barely scratched the surface with it. Unbelievable. Now, we have had the patch. So I'll just bring up the HUD now that you know the prize. So I'll bring up the HUD and yes, this was done before the patch. Now, the patch has lessened some of the prize reward for quick time and that kind of thing when it comes to completing the missions. Now, one of the things I just did off screen, you're probably wondering why I'm driving, is I just checked on the fields, and we got a field of canola over here in field 38, which is, apart from a tiny little strip, is ready to harvest. So I'm going to start taking this up to the up to field 38, so we can get that ready to roll, and we can also start thinking about how we want to spend our £1 million. £1 million. Put your finger in the corner of your mouth and go, "Mwahaha! £1 million." I've got a couple of ideas, but I'm sure you do as well. The first thing we can do, I know you'll be shouting out, buy a blooming jet wash. Please, for the love of God, buy a jet wash. Which we can do, that is not a problem. But with £1 million, we can really start to invest in the farm and get some really cool equipment. So we'll start off by getting the washer, that's fine. And we will also get a front loader, because we definitely need a front loader. Because I want to get cows going and that kind of thing as well. So, to get cows going, we'll also need a mower, won't we, to collect the grass and obviously things to feed them and such. So there you go, we've got that one strip of canola which isn't quite ready. Let's switch her off and go and get the... there we go, this must be the combine. Yes it is, start her up. I'll take it down to field 38 as well. I'll tell you what we can do. Let's just hop out. Let's just go and buy this straight away. Select that. Yes, that. Buy. Woo. Okay. Woo. Okay, that's a little bit super sensitive. Let's pop that about. Yay. Great. Okay. So we've bought ourselves a little washer. Here we go. So let's wash the combine before we take her up for the next harvest. It's what you've been screaming out for, isn't it? Wash the damn combine. It's probably not the done thing leaving the engine running while you're washing it, but hell, we got £1 million, we can afford to burn a bit of fuel. Clean the wheels, it's slowly becoming clean. It's a big bit of kit, so. Well, that's the actual bulk of it. Let's see if we can get this header clean. Headers and front weights seem to be perpetually dirty. They're really difficult to get clean. This is actually coming clean now, which is quite nice. Just takes a long time. I think they've slowed the actual cleaning process down a touch. Feels like it, anyway. There we go. Great! Look at that one brand spanking new shiny combine. Brilliant. Right, so let's take this up to the field 38. I don't think there's need to jump and buying a new combine straight away. I think this combine is serving us pretty well as it is. We could potentially look to go into sugar beet or maybe potato harvesting. Sugar beet will probably be the easier one to jump into straight away because it's not as expensive. I'm also gonna look to sell the crane we have, because that's just not doing it for me, and we can potentially replace that with I'm not gonna get the buffalo or the ponzi scorpion just yet. I think we can probably look to get the trailer with the crane on. I think that'll probably be a little bit more solid to do our forestry work while we're waiting for the crops to grow. But yes, going back to the animals, sheep and cows. So we definitely need to get the mower. We have a forage wagon already, so that's not a problem. We can collect the grass. We will potentially need to look at getting straw as well, but we can just do that via the forage wagon for now. But potentially we can then get a baler and do baling. But let's start off small. Although we got £1 million and plenty of grain in the bank to sell, we can quickly lose that money. There's loads of fields we can potentially buy as well, so we're going to have to be quite not careful, but we can't be reckless with our cash. A fool and his money are easily parted. So, woo, okay. So I start to get a bit of a slide coming out of that. Right, I'm hoping. Don't know why that section hasn't grown. I'm hoping that if we get this one going, we can hire Sebastian to get this field cut, and then we can sell some of the equipment we no longer want and buy some new stuff, which would be quite exciting. So let's get Sebastian going there. There he goes, fantastic. Let's just quickly run down here, jump in this tractor, plonk that on the edge of the field, which will allow it to unload, hopefully. So we plonk it here, it should unload when he comes to stop. Park and brake on, engine off, fantastic. I probably parked too close and he probably can't get down there, but we shall see. Right, so as you can see, that I've left the little hurleyman next to the job board, because that's what I was doing, basically getting the jobs for the various crop sales and then selling them for a bonus, which is the most profitable way of doing it. Right, now let's just quickly reset that crane because it's fallen over. And we'll take that and this tractor down to the down to the shop, and we'll get it sold. Reset that, please. Yes, please. Thank you. Please, thank you. There we go. There we go. Great. Let's spin that round. Let's just give this tractor a quick clean. You know, if we're trying to get some money on it, then we might as well make it look presentable. Okay. Doop, doop, doop. Yeah, you can tell this is going to be pure washing video, isn't it? It's going to be a whole video of just washing implements and tractors. I always find if you aim for the cab, it tends to clean the whole tractor. Rather than doing anything else. Seems to be the way forward. Right, so that looks clean. How do we clean the crane? We've got some muck on that. Boom there. Boom da, boom da. I think that's clean. That'll do. Great. Okay, let's take this down to the shop and see how much we can get for it. We'll leave the weight here because we can reuse that. So what we've got? We've got the forage wagon. We've got a plough. That's pretty much that there. We've got the cedar, and we've got that little tipper trailer, which may potentially go as well. Now, we'll swap this. Well, I say swap. We'll part exchange this for a front loader and a crane with the trailer and crane. Now, the good news is, with the front loader, we'll be able to sell the wood chip as well to the biomass place, the bioheating place. So yeah, we can start to look at maybe wood chips. Wood chips would be something quite interested in getting into if you had a wood chipper. See how much that is actually. It does seem to be a little, because considering we are on the hardest difficulty, it wasn't very hard to get £1 million. Now I know they have patched that in the last patch. Left the engine running, but what the heck? 9,600? Yes. And 30,600? Yes. Okay, well, there we go. We are one Deutz less. So, front loaders. We have potentially got the Steyr, or we have... Where are you? This little New Holland, Dave. 64 grand for this New Holland. It's got 75 brake horsepower. Cost £70 a day. Or we've got these Steyrs, these two, which are 114 brake horsepower and £100 a day. So I'm thinking the Steyr. Yeah, let's get the Steyr. It's too late now. I've done it. So we need the Steyr. Yeah, that's the one we need. So we'll buy that. Now, we don't need a bale spike just yet. Wrapped bale handler, no. Log fork, yes. We'll buy one of those, definitely. Manure fork, potentially. What do we do? That's just manure, whatever that is, and whatever that is. A pallet fork, yes, because we want to look at sheep. Bale, round bale fork, no. Now, the universal bucket will do all of what the manure fork will do and more. Side cutters, we'll just do that. So we'll just get the universal bucket. That seems to be the best way forward. Okay, now, also we wanted this for 54 grand, the stepper. Where's the chipper? There's the chipper, 88 grand. Potentially can get the chipper as well. But we'll maybe come back to that. But for now, we've spent a bit of cash, so we've got 878,000 left, plus all the stuff in the silos. But here we go. So we bought the stepper trailer, as has been shown off many a time, but that should help us no end. We've got the universal bucket there, we've got the pallet fork there, and we've got the log holder there. That's the front loading arms, and this is our Steyr 4115 multi tractor. Look at that nice model. Let's jump in. What's it look like inside? Very nice. Oh, very nice indeed. It was a little bit low res in the middle, but it's disappointing there, and a bit low res up there. But yeah, not bad. Let's start her up. Stick in reverse. Right, now we should be able to just drive into these things and connect them up. Oh, there we go. Now, if we pick up the... I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll pick up the log one, and then we'll reset the other... Whoa, this is actually quite a nifty little tractor. Let's get the angle of the dangle right, and come in forward, and to click. There we go, great. So we've got the log biddy on there. We'll pick up the trailer as well, and we'll reset the other two attachments. And they'll get sent back to the farm, so we'll just pay for delivery. That's what we're basically going to do there. Great, so let's just reset the... oh god, where is it? There we go, the pallet fork, we'll reset that, yes. And we'll reset the universal bucket, yes, okay, great. Brilliant, okay, let's go back to the farm then. With our new toys. Whoa, this has got really soft suspension, I'll tell you that much. Now, I am keeping an eye out for the next best map. There are a couple of maps which have taken my interest, but they're not actually out yet. They're still a work in progress, in development, and hopefully they'll be coming out soon. So yeah, we'll keep an eye on that. Whoa, okay. It's quite a heavy trailer for this little tractor. But yeah, we've got a front loader now. Wow. So with that, we'll need to get some mowers. Most definitely need to get some mowers so we can do the animal feed. We get them grassed just to begin with. We'll buy some cows, and then we can start making milk, which would be great, and obviously that will also start producing manure, which we can then potentially look at getting some greenhouses, and we can fuel those up with the manure. Okay, great. Should we park our trailer in here? Easy does it. Damn it. That tree was not aiding visibility at all. I might have to cut it down. Brilliant. Okay, so we'll just leave the trailer in there for now. And we'll come back to the farm. Potentially this tractor won't be based at this farm, it'll be based down near the cows, but okay, so it's put the they're putting right there, that's fine. Let's stick that weight on the back of this tractor. Whoa, okay, this is a little bit trickier to drive than the other one. When I say trickier, it's just a little bit weirder on the old steering because of the softer front suspension. All I'm saying is I'm a bad driver. That's what I'm basically saying. I'm trying to make excuses for how bad a job I'm doing of this. There we go. And I'm still trying to get used to this new gearbox system. Right, okay, so that's grand. Let's park you out of the way for now. I just wanted to have a look at that. The combine is almost at 80% full. It is 80% full. So let's hop over to him. Yeah, he had been unloaded once, as you can see. Let's start him off and get him down for the combine. Has that edge upgraded? No, that's still not quite right, that last bit of edge, which is okay. Oh, come on. I'm hammering the one key to slow down. There we go. Oh, it's such a bodge job of it. I hate it. Now, I could use the mod I've got installed to use a better set, but I can't be bothered. It's more faffing about, to be honest with you. So let's... There we go. Let's him come. Let's try and add a bit of a pace and try and balance him. There we go. 6 miles an hour. That seems to be the one. Down to 46% full. We'll take him to the end and then stop and let him unload. 20%. Brilliant. Okay. So we'll let him go down the field, and then once he's cleared that next row, we'll go and park on it and we'll leave the tractor there. And once that's done, we can go and have a look at the shop, see what's next for us to purchase. Now, I'm thinking, we've been talking about this a long time, we definitely need a big, strong combine. A big, strong tractor to do all the hard graft and to get things moving. So let's switch that off, park that up, and jump out. So, combine. Tractor-wise. I want something with at least 200 brake, so we are looking at the same has got a 190, the New Holland's got 160, the Case has 203 for 172 grand, the Lamborghini has 220, which is just another 20 grand more. Wow, that. Oh, then we go into big tractor territory, 200, 300, 400, 400. Wow, okay, so what was that one? That was 263 220. Maybe we get the Lamborghini. Do you think the Lamborghini? Ah, I tell you what, we also have mods, tractors. We also have the 263 black edition Deutz. We have that little Lamborghini. Oh, it's only 120. Ignore those. I wasn't that impressed with them, so we can ignore that. Okay, fine. Let's go back. I'm probably thinking then, maybe the Case or the Lamborghini. I know you're all shouting, Lamborghini! Lamborghini! Let's get the Case, because I doubt anyone ever buys... I should get a Lamborghini. Let's see what we want to buy, and then we'll determine what we need there. So, sugar beet is definitely something I am interested in getting into. So let's have a look at sugar beet planter. Will that do sugar beet? So that's the one we got, and it will not do sugar beets. That is potatoes, isn't it? Yeah. This one does... Oh, no, wait, hang on. Is that a sugar beet there? So we can plant sugar beet. Oh, hello. Okay, so let's start with... We're not going to buy that. No, no, no. We're going to buy these. And we'll come back to maybe buying that later. So we'll get the Grimmy front and back. Great, so we need 134, 161. Okay. So, yeah, okay, let's buy that. Okay, and we'll buy that. Okay. And now we need probably a little bit more than 200 horsepower. So let's get the Lamborghini. Buy that. Okay. We're down to 500,000. Our last 500,000. So let's tab over to our new tractor. Here it is, our Lamborghini, looking absolutely beautiful. And we've got our sugar beet front, and which this is the topper. So this basically chops all the leaves off and leaves the this bit here. It's all grubby already, look at that, it's already grubby. This bit will then dig up the sugar beet and stick them in the back. Great, so let's... it's probably easier to put the front attachment on first and then put the second attachment on. For a quick look inside, Lamborghini quality? Oh yes. Oh yes indeed. Oh nice. Good choice, I think. There we go. We've got that. Now let's go and pick up the trailer. Excellente. And we'll put these with our... Oh, hang on. Can we get around there? No. Let's just cut down here then. It's fine. We're in a big off-road vehicle. We can make our own roads. Where we're going, we don't need roads. Okay. So we'll get this back to the farm. I'm keeping an eye on the combine. It looks like it's unloading in the trailer right as we speak, which is great. Now we shouldn't see too much slowdown with this tractor pulling this combine up here. Oh, it's a little bit, but that's a, oh yeah, it's quite a bit actually. I don't think any of the other tractors will be able to handle this sort of weight of load, which is quite good. So we'll get this up here. Wow, we really have been spending today, haven't we? Maybe a little bit too recklessly, but we're going to definitely get sugar beet. So the small field, we'll put sugar beet in, just to make sure it's working and everything. We do need to sell some before we harvest it, so that's not going to be a... Shouldn't be a problem, we can get some of that sold. Wow. Yeah, this is not the kind of thing you want dragging up and down hills all day. Yeah, it's going to be a bit of a weird episode, isn't it? I say that every time, but this is going to be literally spending money. Some of you will be loving it, some of you will be hating it. I can understand both viewpoints, to be honest. Right, so there we go. That's safely tucked away. Let's pop this in here as well. Brilliant. Okay. I can see me just driving this tractor for the time being now, because I'm going to love this Lamborghini, but we got lots of other stuff to do as well. We can potentially sell that little Hurleyman now. Wow, this gets 38 miles an hour. Woohoo! Well, let's leave it there. Great, so we've got two new tractors. We've got the front loader attachments as well, and we've got the sugar beet harvesting equipment, and also the better harvest... the stepper log harvesting wagon. Now, you're at 32%, so you're okay. We can leave you for the time being. Great, we'll just follow up and park where he's just cutting now. Same old little thing. potentially we can sell that little Hurleyman. We'll keep this Deutz because I think three tractors is probably, whoa, a nice number. For now, anyway. Let's park you there. Switch you off. Okay, so now let's... Where on this map are the... So the sheep are right in the top corner with near field 4, and the cows are kept... Where are the cows kept? There they are, down near field 40, near the biogas plant. Okay, so... We do need to get a mower, because we need to start collecting some grass. We could probably just get away with a front mower for now, 13 grand. We'll buy that. I'll reset it so we don't have to go and get it. I'm sure you're probably bored of heading to and fro from the shop. Harvest? No, we don't need another harvester. It's doing everything we need, unless we can get a corn cutter for the Sampo. Can we get... That would be under headers, of course, wouldn't it? Can we get a corn cutter for the... what was it? The Sampo? Sampo? This works for the... no. Okay. It's the area of flow. That's the... Okay, that's New Holland. Okay, it doesn't seem like it's compatible. Is that a thing? Hang on. What is... It's definitely called the... it's the Commia. The Commia C6. There was definitely a corn cutter for the C6. The Commia C6. What about that one? No. So that we could potentially get a corn cutter as well for 18 grand. I think we'll buy that. We'll get yellow as well, which will go with the combine. So we've got the sower, this one, which will do corn. Now we've got the cutter, so we can collect corn as well. So that's corn, sugar beet we can now do as well. Fantastic. What else do we need? We've got the loading wagon. We potentially go into bale technology. Wow, is that the round baler picker-upper? We could potentially get the round baler picker-upper with the round baler. Tempting. That's a wrapper, isn't it? And that's the big bale stacker. Okay, well, that's... Do you want to get the baling equipment? We could get the slurry equipment. We'll probably get some slurry equipment anyway. And bearing in mind... Do you know what? I think we've probably got enough money to do everything now, which is kind of disappointing. I'm looking at this thinking, this is not too hard at all to do. We've got the bale shredder, which we can potentially get if we get the baler. We've got the mixing wagon, then we've got the automated mixing wagon, or mixing vehicle. We've got the tedder and the windrow if we want to go into hay. Auger wagons to transfer it to different fields. We don't have to worry about that. Any more new cars? It's just the car for 59 grand, should we want it. Animals. Obviously, we want to get the cows and the sheep in. This suddenly feels incredibly... Not easy. Easy would be the wrong word, but... Less of a challenge, doesn't it? Yeah. So, okay. I guess we could just upgrade everything. It feels kind of meh, doesn't it? Now that we're in a position where we're kind of in a position to get everything we want straight away. Slightly disappointing to me anyway, but hey ho. Let's move some of this stuff about, shall we? Get out of the way. Let's stick the log thing down there. Keep an eye on the combine. It's currently at 51% full, so that's doing okay. Now, this front loader, obviously, it'll be used for mucking out or putting the muck into for the any greenhouses we buy. Can also use it to ship and ferry the wood chips and everything like that. So that's potentially going to be very useful. So I'm not sure exactly if that's going to stay at one of the animal farms or one of the biogas plant or something like that, when we can load the wood chips and stuff in there. Right, let's get this. Whoop! It's gone horribly wrong. Right, we do also have that mess I made up at the train track to go and clear up. But for now, let's just collect this. Great, that went really well. Drop that down a bit. Come on, connect up. There we go, fantastic. And if we can just move this front mower as well. I've never realised how small that corn cutter was. Will this tractor move that? Oh yeah, yeah it will. Oh yeah it will. This tractor's got a big heart, look at that. Brilliant, but look how small that corn cutter is. Wow, I thought it was a bit bigger than that. But anyway, we're coming up to the half hour mark, which means, you know, I've rattled on long enough and bored you long enough. Let's get this started. We're coming up to the end of this field anyway, so I'll probably just tidy this field up offline. And what I need from you is, what do you want us to look at? You know, we've got so much we can potentially look at. We've got baling technology. Do you want to upgrade, like, the slurry tanker? We'll get a slurry tanker when we get the cows. We also need the muck spreader. We obviously have to wait for the animals to actually generate the muck first, but then we could potentially go into greenhouses. Let me know your thoughts. We got so much cash, so much seed and everything, we can potentially do whatever we like. Obviously, we can't buy all the big stuff straight away, but we can pretty much buy probably all the starter equipment to get us going in pretty much every arena. So, yes, things have been very lucrative since we threw those old coins down the wishing well. Your decision? I take no responsibility. But yeah, we're in a very comfortable position now. So I'll let this guy, well, let Sebastian continue up and down the field until we finish what we can and wait for that to go ripe, and then we'll just tidy this field up. And then next time I will start with the shopping list that you have recommended. So I don't know why he lost speed there. There you go, 6 miles an hour. Brilliant. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. Thoughts and comments please leave below, and I will follow your guidance when purchasing further equipment and or animals. And join me next time for more Farm Sim 15. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.